Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Otter Sam back here today in another episode of Fallout New Vegas. It is a beautiful day in the Fallout world. Sir Dingleberg II is fully sober. And look at this guy. I get some beer. That was a terrible joke. Last time, we arrived right here on the New Vegas Strip in New Vegas. We are dead center in it, so we are not... Oh, actually, yes, we are in front of the Gamora. It's been a while, I haven't done an actual mission. Because we were too busy just exploring. Anyways, so I... Yeah. There we are. We got that swaggerness going on here. Who was the Ultralux?
Beg your pardon, but could I trouble you to turn over your weapons?
Those masks creep me out.
My deepest apologies for the slightest inconvenience. You have my assurance that everything will be returned upon your departure. But we simply can't have anyone waving their weapons around in the hotel. It's not the atmosphere we wish to cultivate.
Okay, buddy.
Please, enjoy your stay. Yeah. They'll be handled with the utmost security in our bank. Farewell.
I got the holdouts. I don't remember what my holdouts are, but I don't think I'll need them yet. Well, yeah, there's that guy for that quest. Forgot the name of the quest. Let's check what the quest is, right? Okay. Nope. Wrong thing. Yeah, that was mine. You never know how to do this. I wanted to do Cass first. Who are you? Why is this guy in here?
You watch yourself around Mr. Gunderson.
What is he? Oh, him. Oh, I remember him.
Beg your pardon, stranger, but I'm looking for someone. You ain't seen a young man with dark brown hair and a white hat on lately, have you? Ain't nobody got one darn piece of news about my boy. Not one lousy speck of information. Ain't got one Brahmin unaccounted for across a dozen ranches. But I'm here for an hour and my own son just up and disappears on me.
What is he, like five?
Yep, got a whole mess of Brahmins to my name. Bighorners, too. Used to just have the one ranch, but land was easy to grab before the soldiers moved in. Before I knew it, I was running one of the biggest ranching operations east of California. Now everywhere I go, folks I never even met shake my hand and call me Mr. Gunderson. Don't quite know what to make of that. Made me a special arrangement with the hotel. They want to do business with me, they got to play by my rules. A lot of people out there resent success, might want to take a swipe at me. This makes them think twice. If I'd have been thinking, though, I'd have had him watching my boy instead. Then none of this would have happened. My boy, Ted. He was right here. I didn't leave him but a minute. I told him to stay put while I talked some things over with the White Glove folks. He was never one to stay tied down to a spot, though. Gets that from his mother. Got most of my staff out looking for him now. I'd be out myself, but I keep hoping he'll show up back here. Of course, if he does that, I'll whoop him till his skinny hide turns to leather for putting me through this. But that don't mean I wouldn't be grateful. That's between me and the White Glove Society. But let's just say they control the food supply around here, and I got lots of food to give. But that ain't as welcome as you might think. That's what they call themselves, the folk that run this place. They're the ones dressed all fancy with their bow ties and shiny dresses.
I know it's already.
Some of them got masks,
letting
too.
You guys know.
Real hard to trust what? Folks like that.
Yeah.
A couple of them show their faces, and that's who I do my business with. I don't talk to none of the other ones. I'll be here.
I want to help Ethel, so... Yeah, I'm not going to save his son. We don't care about his son. Is that his son? That would have been sad. It's like, oh man, I think you need to check your eyes. Well, that's this casino. It's a very creepy ass casino. It's very typical luxury. It's kind of boring. You got those creep.
How may I be of service, sir? My, such a popular question. I suppose it is only natural to see us and wonder what it is that makes us special. The White Glove Society has only just made itself known to the public, of course, but our pedigree was established over generations. Were we always so refined? I'd be lying if I said yes. But I've always felt we were destined for a place atop modern society. And now, here we are.
Very old.
Not everyone can wear the finest clothes and eat the finest foods, obviously. That's just the reality we live in. But surely we can agree that the most tasteful, sophisticated people are the most deserving. And that's what the White Glove Society is all about.
White.
I do, but I need someone I know I can rely on, and I haven't heard a thing about you. Perhaps if you made more of a name for yourself around the Strip, we could talk. But not before. Indeed.
And that is where we will go in a moment. There's the Mormoner. I don't know what his quest is. I cannot remember. Look, guys, it's been a while. I play this game a lot. I don't remember exactly everything. There's some stuff I don't want to quite spoil yet.
Hello?
Gonna go to Gamora. Gamora's probably my favorite hotel. Just cause it's...
Hey, fellow, welcome to the Topps Hotel and Casino. I'm gonna have to ask you to hand over any weapons you might be carrying.
Oh, this is the Topps.
Smooth and easy, just the way I like it. Don't worry, they'll be as safe as kittens till you're ready to leave. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, just don't wear them openly. You dig? Now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make your Topps experience the Topps? Have a good time, baby.
Yeah. I thought that was Gamora. Turns out I was wrong. I got the Gamora lights. Guess I should've seen the fucking sign there, but whatever. Yeah, we talked to that guy last time.
You again? You should meet my bookie. You have something in common. Every time I talk to you, I lose caps. Geez, some people.
This guy's funny. Ooh, baby.
Dancing makes me... Honey, what's your name?
My name is Dinkabilly the Second. Damn, girl, you're fine!
Check my moves, honey.
I am, honey.
Check my moves, honey.
I am.
Check my moves.
That's
honey.
All you say. Ooh. Oh, gee, I feel it.
Hey there, friend. A bit of advice. You look like you could use some protection. Lucky for you,
Mr. Holdout, jeez, you did a giant zoom in on the...
All kinds of easy-to-hide weapons for slipping into and out of casinos. They won't give you a second glance. Things guards can't spot when they're
backing
you down
or checking for iron or drink. Chest of this woman.
An experienced smuggler could get a machine gun or pistol in. You? You're welcome to try. Simple. You can't bring guns into the casino, that's why. They'll strip you to your fists. Sure, they say you get it all back when you leave. Me? I don't like being without a little insurance when it's my caps on the table. Take a look at these beauties.
What does he have? Don't remember what I have. My snuggles are pretty good. Spiking. Sure, why not? There he is. Oh, it's him. There he is. Just zoomed in her tits right there.
You like it, huh?
Do it. Wow.
You like it, huh? Hey, baby. There's more of this waiting for you inside.
Yep. Yeah. Wait, who's clapping? She is! She likes it.
You like it, huh?
Yeah, you could probably tell what's going on in this casino. Anyways, Mr. Holdout, there he is. There he is. Ginger. A little too hard last night, man. There we go.
Hey. No one but Omeritas are allowed to carry guns into Gamora. Check your weapons with me. You'll get these back on your way out.
Where's the... this famous, famed, famed, chamed, samamed... I don't even know what I'm saying right now. Casino. Elevator! I want to go in the back. This is not the right way. Woo, woo. Clap, clap, clap. There's always this red guy in there. I don't know who that guy is. I don't remember, actually. I don't remember. It's been such a long time. It's been so long, I don't remember. There it is, the courtyard. You're gonna love this.
Well, what do we have here, huh? Let me guess. You've heard about the mistress who makes all your fantasies come true. So you followed the call of your desires, all the way to the arms of Joanna. Moi. Now that you've found me, I wonder, do you have what it takes?
Do I? But she asked for like 100 and only have 300. A little less than 300 now. Oh, I need to upgrade my speech.
Not too bright, huh? It Damn. Takes caps, honey. Lots of them.
Damn.
All right, honey. What do you want to know? Yes.
She does kind of look washed out.
Oh, nothing special, hun. I'm the best lay in Gamora, and that's all you need to know.
I wasted so much of my money here.
I like that you're here. Doesn't that make you happy?
Okay, we'll do it once.
We can have more fun together, but it's not going to be free, hun. Fine. Are you ready? Follow me, hun.
Yeah. 100, that's a lot. So, I need like 1,000 bajillion caps if I can like get certain go back the second here laid so many times. But I'm showing this because I'm showing this. So you know. This guy's just staring at plants. Yep. Yeah, they're just sitting in these shitty shithole beds. She's taking her sweet long time. I'll try to make this episode shorter. Try. Doesn't mean it might happen, folks, but I'll try. And I try. And I try. Don't get no. Banana. Satisfaction. Banana. Sorry. It's a good song.
Come here, baby. I'm all yours. Are you ready to be all mine?
She quit the smokes there. I'm ready.
Okay. Lay down and I'll take care of you.
You know what's gonna happen. She's about to go down. She insta-changed. Yeah. There's no nudity. Don't worry. Yep, you heard it, did you? I am well rested, yes I am. Oh, insta-dressed again.
Come here, baby, I'm all yours. Are you ready to be all mine? Okay, lay down and I'll take care of you.
Yeah, it won't do it again because I have to pair. So I'm done. You heard it, you know. You know why I like... No, well, I just like because this concealer's the brightest. It's interesting, too, because it's the only concealer that has this. Hello, man, who's still staring at plants. Well, now he's staring at me. What a creep. Whee! Drink that fresh fountain water. Probably sitting there for, like, such a long time. Yeah, it's a nice courtyard. Very good. See the texture mod added. It makes the nice red better. Like it was just ridiculous before. Now it's just... It's nice. It's nice. Yeah, you can talk to this lady too. They're the only two that you can get. Dazzle, huh?
Hey there, sugar. I'm Dazzle.
I'm dazzled by
what
you.
What can I do for you? Or to you? You're so handsome, I might just give you a discount. Well now, that's unusual. Normally no one cares enough to ask. To be honest, I don't rightly know. My mama was from around these parts. I can remember her face, but not her name. More than I can remember of my daddy, I guess. We lived in Westside before the Omertas bought me. As bad as it can be some days in here, it's better than living in that dump. 100 caps, no kissing, no rough stuff.
You know, and Lady Killer Perk helps.
Yeah, you are different from my usual guys. Fine. 50 caps, but don't tell anyone. We can go right over here, baby.
Amazed. But she doesn't do the sounds, unlike Joanna. Joanna is the beast. Yep. That's about it. I'm not gonna waste too much more of my money. And there's this guy staring in fire. Lincoln sideburns.
What are you looking at?
The hell are you looking at, you punk, you bitch ass cracker, you cracker. But yeah, there's one little oddity around here, and then we're is that a, no? Okay, I thought it was an ash pile. Okay, I didn't research what the Vault 13. Canteen drinking thing does yet. I still got to research that don't know. Meow, meow, meow. Oh, I saw the teat.
What do you need? Bye.
Here's just talk to. Oh yeah, and you think it's all girls, right? You think it's all women prostitutes, right? No, there is men. It's kind of creepy that it's sort of like, hey, relax, grab a girl, or if you want a guy. And you think it's good as a normal prostitution area with women. Well, no, okay, there's the guy, occasional guys. and you think it to be creepy to the guys. Look at this. This is creepier. Ghoul prostitutes.
Hey, big guy. Looking for a good time?
Both male ghoul and female ghoul prostitutes. It's creepy with the female. Look at the male, though. Look at that flesh. You want to bang that? Ghouls are nice. They can be nice, you know, but they look kind of ugly.
What do you need? Later.
Oh my god! The way he said later was like...
Later.
It's so creepy. It's like... He's like, hey there, big guy. What do you need?
Later.
Okay, too much. Okay, that's... Okay. That was hilarious. That was funny.
There's some serious shit going on between NCR and the Legion. You better not fuck with our power.
Ow, I hit my head on the door frame. I'm jumping up and down. That red guy, I'm struggling to remember who the fuck he is. Who the fuck he is. I don't remember who he is. Broken slot machines in this game, love them.
Hey, big guy, looking for a good time?
It is time to go to Lucky 38 to talk to Mr.
Well, howdy, partner. Good to see you again. Boss is waiting for you upstairs, so get a move on.
Thank you,
come back soon now.
Thank you. Stank face. No.
Where to, partner?
To the penthouse.
Penthouse floor.
Who are you?
Well, hello, sugar.
Oh, it's Jane.
Mr. House is waiting for you in his office.
Forgot about her.
I'm Jane, one of Mr. House's girls. Keep him entertained. We don't get many guests lately. Perhaps we can entertain you as well.
Oh, damn. Robot sex. That is kind of weird.
There's lots of things to tell, I'm sure. There's the three families, the casinos, the other attractions. What would you like to know?
Tell them about the three families.
They're just new money, sugar. They might pretend they're sophisticated, but between you and me, they're not far off from tribals. Emeritus especially are just awful brutes. The chairman and the White Glove Society at least pretend to have some culture.
Yeah, that's about them.
Well, of course, there used to be a lot more of them. But these days, there are three open to the public. The Tops, the Ultra Lukes, and Gamora.
Ultra Lukes.
And the Lucky 38, of course. But we're not open to the public. You're a special case, sugar. Well, let's see. The NCR has an embassy here. But why you'd want to go talk to a bunch of boring old politicians, I surely don't know. Oh, and the Vault 21 Hotel and Gift Shop has an adorable collection of old Vault-Tec memorabilia. And I suppose
the music
if you
in
like
so
neon
eerie.
Signs, you might check out Michelangelo's sign shop. Anything you like, sugar. Not many people know this, but Mr. House is one of the world's biggest collectors of antique snow globes.
I have one.
If you happen to find any out in the wasteland, you can bring them to me, and I'll add them to his collection. You'll get a reward, of course. In fact, one of Mr. House's favorites went missing when we moved the collection. If you have a look around the Lucky 38, you might even find it. You do? Why,
whoa.
That's just
well,
wonderful.
That just made up for the two
I'll
sexes.
I'll take it and put it with the rest of the collection.
Party sex fun thing that I had.
Why? I'm a Robco PDQ-88B Mark 1 Securitron.
That's a long ass
you
name.
Silly goose.
You silly goose. Of course I didn't know that.
On the market. This is the Lucky 38 Resort and Casino. Or it used to be. Mr. House has kept the place locked up tight for ages now. Nobody comes in or out.
Except you robots.
Why, sugar? He's the maximum utmost. If it weren't for Mr. House, we wouldn't have this fabulous wonderland of New Vegas, would we? Well, of course I am, silly. Mr. House is just the smartest, most wonderful man there ever was. Why, did you know he single-handedly reclaimed New Vegas from all those nasty tribes that used to live here? Well, he single-handedly sent in his Securitrons to do it, but that counts in my book. Sugar, I may be a robot on the outside, but on the inside, my neurocomputational matrix is an exact copy of Mr. House's favorite girl.
So you're, what? A copy of a dead woman?
Mr. House has a lot of needs, sugar. I take care of all of them, and a lady doesn't kiss and tell. Then maybe you shouldn't pry into a lady's particulars, Anything you like, sugar.
I don't know why I always get disoriented. I don't know why. I think it's here. Yep.
This meeting has been a long time coming, hasn't it? You've come a long ways, literally and, I suspect, figuratively as well. I have to ask, now that you've reached your destination, what do you make of what you see?
Scary.
Of course you haven't. Vegas always was one of a kind. What you see down on the strip is just a fraction of the city's former glory, and yet, more than an echo, I preserved its spirit. Or perhaps you were referring to the Lucky 38? The years haven't been kind to her, but still she manages to impress. Oh, don't be coy. You've been playing a high-stakes game ever since Victor dug you out of the ground. Don't be afraid to admit it. The business is this. One of my employees has stolen an item of extraordinary value from me, and I want it recovered. Simple enough. My only concern is the recovery of the platinum chip. What happens to Benny, I leave to your discretion. When you bring the chip to
Benny, that's something.
I will pay you 4 times the delivery bonus stipulated in your contract. How's that?
Oh, bar is so low, I shouldn't have tied up there.
Well enough. Return to me when you have the platinum chip in your possession. Any final matters for us to discuss? What did you wish to know? It won't be easy. Benny is always surrounded by at least 4 bodyguards, except when he's in his private suite on the 13th floor of the Tops. It's more complicated than that. The chairmen share what you might call a tribal affinity. Look for a man named Swank, Benny's second in command. He's always been a reliable, if unimaginative, employee. Do your best to convince him that you're working under my auspices. If you have evidence of Benny's crimes, show it to him. By contract, Securitrons are to enter the casinos only when invited by the 3 families, or if other extraordinary circumstances arise.
Interesting.
The moment I send one into the Tops, Benny will know I'm on to him. If you were to approach Benny in public, you might be able to leverage his fear of exposure to make him agree to meet with you in private. Sneaking into Benny's suite on the 13th floor would be very difficult, but not impossible. There might be guards. Certainly there'd be a sturdy lock on his front door. What else did you want to know?
Yes.
Benny has led the chairman ever since I recruited his tribe 7 years ago. Until his recent misbehavior, I'd planned to make him my protege. Maybe if I'd begun grooming him sooner, none of this would have happened. To achieve my aims, I require a capable human agent to perform certain
so much talking.
Tasks.
There was some talking, some speeches he gave. I never did in the past.
But I believed he would do the job so long as he was incentivized appropriately. Obviously, I miscalculated his drive for supremacy. But in any case, you've come along. A more than suitable replacement. I have to think that he found out about the Platinum Chip and mistakenly convinced himself that he could use it to his own ends. One of the problems of a tribal workforce, I'm afraid. No intuitive understanding of how complex technologies can be. Why didn't Victor intervene sooner, you mean? Good Springs is a bit too far away for me to reliably control a Securitron agent by remote. I can send and receive packets of data at best. Victor's combat algorithms determined the proper course of action. Benny and his thugs were more than a match for a lone Securitron. When he alerted me, I instructed him to approach the site after Benny and the others had departed. What else did you want to know? It's a very special item. There's nothing else like it in the entire world. Mm-hmm. It was lost a long time and difficult to find. That's all you need to know about it for this stage of our enterprise. Fulfill your contract, deliver the chip, and good things will come your way. You realize you were just one of many couriers. The rest of them... dummies, so to speak. Add to that many thousands of caps worth of mercenary protection to screen your avenue of approach. Had I used an armed caravan to transport the chip, I might as well have been announcing to the world, "This is important! Attack this!" I didn't want to attract the attention of groups like the Great Khans or the Brotherhood of Steel. Alas, the real threat was closer to home. Frontal assaults on casinos? Not good for business. In any case, Benny would see it coming, and all he'd have to do is hold the chip up and point a pistol at it. Our foremost advantage is that Benny doesn't know that I know he has the chip. Let's not squander it. What else did you want to know? I am Robert Edwin House. President, CEO, and sole proprietor of the New Vegas Strip. I oversaw the city's renovations starting from 2274.
Mr. House is supposed to make fun of,
The three families are my employees.
He's supposed to impersonate, you know,
I was the founder, president, and CEO
Hughes.
Of Robco Industries.
Howard Hughes.
A vast computer and robotics corporation.
Yeah, he's supposed to be, like... He's supposed to, like... present like Howard Hughes, like the man quiet, you know.
Don't let
big
the video screens,
you know?
And computer terminals fool you. I'm flesh and blood, not silicon. Let's just say it was very costly.
Yeah.
But I was willing to make the sacrifices longevity entailed, financial and otherwise.
Okay.
We can discuss this in greater detail at another time. Suffice it to say that when my Securitrons detected NCR scouts at Hoover Dam, I took action. I recruited a tribal force to supplement my Securitrons and renovated the strip just in time to welcome the NCR as it marched into the region. Instead of war, a treaty was negotiated and the money started to pour in. Don't let the video screens and computers...
Yeah, I already said that.
What else did you want to know? It's understandable that you'd be curious about this topic, but we'll hold off until the platinum chip has been recovered. What else did you want to know? Well enough. Be on your way.
Police. It's the police. Fuck the police. The police. Fuck the police. The police.
Congratulations, partner. The boss has instructed me to comp you to the high roller suite.
Yeah.
You can bring your friends too. Be like a little clubhouse for the gang you put together. Just bear in mind, you're
good.
The only one gets to see the boss.
Yeah.
Any friends you got, they can wait in the suite. Enjoy the dates, partner. They're plenty fancy.
Okay. Present to the suite.
High roller suite.
So much stuff to look at. The creepy eerie music. Oh my god, it's a baseball cap! Those glasses? No way. Taking that, I'm gonna put those on. Gotta make it more Sir Dinkleberg like, if you know what I mean. Glasses. Yes. Can't see his face. Damn it. Should've known that, actually. Nah, they're just chips. Take juice! Take that later. We don't need that yet. Ooh, feature weapons today. And look at the other rooms. That's the bathroom, that's nice. Got to have the Braxo cleaner. Yes, drink out the toilet, it's lovely. And we be walking here. Good point. I love how it just falls on the floor, bobby pin. I'm full right now, that's why I'm not taking anything. Come back later. We can delete all this later. Someone fly. Every time you take something in this game, the stuff just go bloop and float on top. Because it's weird. But I got everything that's in here, which is cool. Oh, this is mine. It is mine, even though it's kind of useless. It's a globe. Yeah, that's my suite, so I'm just gonna go back down now.
Where to, partner?
Mama.
Casino floor.
I should actually legit grab a gun out. What did I have before? Not what I meant to do.
Hey, you there. I have a message for you. It's from Ambassador Crocker. Very important. Here you go.
Ambassador Crocker is the NCR ambassador. at Vault 21.
Nobody's ever been inside that place.
That one must be important around here.
Check that out. He just left the Lucky 38. Dead.
I'm a G like that. Yeah, run away! Run away, beasts! Run away, beasts! Yeah. Is this free sign? Oh, we got the music going on. Vault 21.
Hey.
Uh-huh. 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 Is that all you got to say? Huge. Damn. You just a stanky ass trailer. Hello, Michelangelo. Oh yeah, this place. It's been a long ass time. Hello, lady friend. Hello.
Hi. What can I do for
hey,
you?
Hello, Kate.
He's the reason the strip shines like a star at night. Mike's imagined and built every sign, billboard, and light you'll see around here. Check out the back of the shop. He's usually working there. He's the reason the strip shines like a star at night. Mike's imagined
damn,
and built
Kate,
every sign,
yeah,
billboard,
gotta,
and light you'll see
you
around
know.
Here. Bye.
There's another dialogue option.
Welcome back. Need anything? You saw our front sign, didn't you? This is where all the beautiful signs of the strip become a reality. It all comes from Michelangelo's imagination. We do a little work here and there too, sure, but he's the real artist. I've been here over a year now, though I'm not one to get tired for long.
Yeah.
I plan to roam the wasteland once I'm ready. The people need light and kindness. There's too much fear and pain out there already.
You know, right? Yeah, I know there.
Bye.
Too much fear and pain. Oh, that must have hurt. I like someone's breathing. Scared the shit out of me. There he is. He looks pretty young. Vault 21.
Oh, hello. I am Michelangelo. How can I? Wait. Are you here to deliver more billboard requests? Please tell me you're not a messenger on behalf of Mr. House. Because spending myself to the edge of artistic oblivion for Mr. House sums up my existence since I had to leave Vault 21. That's why. Well, I... not much, really. Vault 21 was my home. My dear home. I left it to explore the outside world. At first, it was a marvel to behold. My inspiration flowed true, and its works caught Mr. House's attention. And that's how I ended up in this place. I feel haunted by something terrible. Working in such a huge workshop often makes me shiver. I can't even leave the strip. Yes, I think so. But please, keep quiet about it. Without inspiration, I'm as good as a tumbleweed drifting in the barren wasteland. Wouldn't that be great? No, Mr. House filled it with concrete. Only a few rooms and halls remain. My sister was able to turn them into a hotel. Most people don't understand what it means to grow up in a vault. Corridors,
oh, no.
Its walls radiate a warmth that feels safe, honest. But here, everything is huge and threatening. So empty that I think one of these days I'll just snap. You mean Mitch? Oh, it's been ages since I've heard the name. My sister and I used to call him Mole Butt. Don't ask. That was a long time ago. Before we exchanged the warmth of our home for the thin air of the wasteland. Oh, all right. So, bye. Oh, what do you want? Most people don't...
There's other stuff.
What do you want? I am Sheldon, from Vault 21. Although here I go by my artistic name, Michelangelo.
There's another thing.
Oh,
need all the information.
Want? Well, I... not much. It's this place. My inspiration ebbs and I don't know how to stop it. Oh, I can't feel the warmth anymore. Oh, all right. So, bye.
You're a pretty chill guy. I'm gonna try to leave now, if I can leave. It's a maze up in here! Well, That's great, guys. I was here.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on that.
Whoa. Okay, guys. I think that's it for this episode. Next episode, we will... try... or no, we will go see that white glove guy. The... whatever his name is again. About his quest there. And... if we have time, we might explore Freeside? Till then.